in school, the kids started calling me Iron Man because I was just this little 5'5", 110-pound kid with a gimp hand, and they just started calling me Iron Man, and so that kind of stuck all throughout high school. And when I started wrestling, I was like, Iron Man's really generic. And so in retrospect, it's kind of a crappy name, but it always stuck, and I guess it works.
Kind of been a staple at Smash.
He's a good guy, good kid, good attitude.
Every time I get to see him, he never ceases to amaze me. Just blows me away.
Anyone that kind of overcomes anything like that and to participate in a physical activity, so something as physical as pro wrestling, it's very interesting and interesting to see him perform tonight.
I've had the pleasure of wrestling him twice, and just a top-tier quality guy.
He's been here for, I guess, about a year and a half now. Very happy member of our team. He's professional, he's funny, and he's a genuine nice guy, but also hyper-competitive. Like, he wants to be the best. He doesn't settle for anything less, and I think it's a good balance between being the nice guy and, you know, having that drive to do well.
Which match are you expecting the most?
I have a few matches that I'm expecting to be really, really good. Alex Vega and Brent Banks is going to be, it should be a really good match. One of the matches I'm really looking forward to is Tyson Dukes and Gregory Iron.
I was born premature, like a month premature. I was born 1 pound. They didn't know that I had cerebral palsy right from birth. At about 10 months old, my dad, he was laid off from his job at the time, so he was taking care of me while my mom was working. And he kind of noticed that as he would sit me on the living room floor, all my toys and stuff would be around me, and I would always grab everything with my left hand, and I would kind of clinch my right. So no matter where the toys were, I was always grabbing with my left. So they started to think, you know, something's got to be wrong. Fix it? Like, that was always my question growing up, because I was getting teased and ridiculed. So when I was about 11, I got taken to the doctor because I wanted to try to get surgery or something, and that's when they told me, well, you have cerebral palsy, that's technically brain damage, so it can never be fixed. And that's the moment for me where it kind of sank in, and it was like, ugh. The first major event I remember as a kid, being like 3 years old, was watching WrestleMania 6, Hulk Hogan and The Ultimate Warrior, The Ultimate Challenge, and I fell in love from that moment on, you know, I was hooked. Wrestling for me was almost an escape. You know, a lot of kids had like Batman or Superman or Spider-Man, but like for me, my superheroes were the WWF wrestlers, these larger-than-life characters I saw on TV. And anytime something was going wrong in my life, you know, I gravitated towards them. It was my way to forget, you know, how rough things were going in my personal life. Wrestling was like really, it was the only thing that I cared about as far as sports as I got older. And even that was one of those things where it was like, I didn't understand like that you could be a wrestler. So it was never one of those things where I thought, well, if I can't play baseball or football, I'm going to be a wrestler. Like it never even crossed my mind that these guys can get paid to be professional wrestlers. Wrestling, for me, again, I was never someone that was very athletic. You know, I started lifting weights when I was 16, and I'd like to tell you that it was because, you know, I thought I was going to be this great wrestler, but I did it because I wanted to impress girls, and I thought that you have to have muscles, because I couldn't get a girlfriend if my life depended on it. So, So I started lifting weights because of that, and after I saw Zach Gowen, who wrestled with one leg on WWE television, that was kind of one of the first moments that I thought to myself, maybe it's possible for someone with a disability to be athletic and to do this. I got a flyer, I called a hotline number on it. And by hotline number, it was really just someone's phone number. It was like a 216 area code, which is Cleveland area code. And I called that, and a woman picks up the phone. I can hear a baby crying in the background. And me, like an idiot, I go, is this the Cleveland All-Pro Wrestling hotline? And she goes, yeah, hold on a second. She puts me on the phone with this guy, JT Lightning, who was training wrestlers at the time. And I distinctly remember him saying, well, let me ask you this question. Is wrestling in your heart? And I remember when he said that to me, like I got this lump in my throat. And I'm not ashamed to say that I'm a pretty emotional guy. But when it comes to wrestling, I'm more emotional than most things. I, for whatever reason, maybe it's because I've always been so attached to it. I got that lump in my throat when he asked me if it was in my heart. And I said, yeah, wrestling's in my heart. And he told me to come down to school and try out to be a wrestler. I was so afraid that if I failed at it, that I would look at wrestling different. So it took a lot of courage.
I saw Greg wrestle the first time when I came to Smash, and I was just so impressed. I mean, I'm a multiple amputee. To see a guy with, you know, cerebral palsy jump in the ring and just kill it, you know, it's really awesome, and it's a great win for the challenge community. Because I can relate to him, I guarantee you it's not as difficult for him as everybody else thinks, right? Just like anybody else, you put your mind to something and you work hard at it, no matter what it is, no matter what your limitations or your abilities are, you're gonna be great at it. And you see that drive in Gregory every time he hits the ring. my passion is wrestling, and I'm a good mouth, right? I would love to get in to be a manager of some sort. And seeing Greg get in the ring and take bumps, you know, it makes me look and think, you know what, why can't I get out there and be a manager?
It's just cerebral palsy is tough, man. It's I don't know how he does it, but he does it, and it's just one of those things you can't explain. He's got that heart.
You know, he's a bit smaller anyway, and then when they see that, like, you know, oh, he's got these other potential limitations, and then like watch how he can wrestle and what he can do, and that he's not really all that limited after all. I think that's really surprising, but I think his whole story is so inspirational.
When I look in the mirror, I don't see Greg with, like, I don't know, a halfway decent physique. I see, like, pimply-faced Greg when he's, like, 14 years old and I'm insecure. Like, I'm that guy. You know what I mean? Like, I'm always still in that mindset. I think we're all our own biggest critics. And so, like, I don't think I'm anything special. You know what I mean? I just happen to be doing what I love. Knowing what it's like to go through bullying and a hard upbringing, you know, with my parents and the disability, like, I think a lot of people can relate to me. It goes deeper than wrestling, and that's why I'm so blessed and thankful to, like, be able to portray the character. It's not, and when I say portray character, like, I mean, it's me. It's an extension of me. I mean, I live with this every day. I'm thankful that I get to have this disability that I always thought was a curse as a child, because now I realize what a blessing it is, because I get to share my story. And for those 8, 10, 12, 20 minutes in the ring, I get to give back, you know? So that's what it's all about.
I think that taps into something that a lot of people, like, is really resonant with them. So,
this is going on your documentary.
Cut that out.